Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Experiencing another frustrating day with the 3.5 SBCG gasoline generator from Westerbeke. Actually, it's a great little generator, very quiet. But anyways, the temperature sensor went out on me. So I called a few local Westerbeke mechanics. All of them said they're at least 2 to 3 weeks out. The part, they said, was 2 to 3 weeks out to order. This is the temperature sensor, coolant temperature sensor. I'm going slow here so you can see the part number. And that's it right there. It was definitely bad. So what you just saw was the owner's manual, but it doesn't tell you how to test it. You need 10,000 ohms. When it's not plugged in, you touch each side of the cable here. See that in there? And that's what you should receive. But somewhere up there, I was receiving like pretty much zero. So I knew it was probably bad. The way I knew it was bad, because there is a light, temp engine light, on the control panel of the generator, which I'll show you right now. Here's the generator. Great little generator, so quiet you can barely hear it. But there is, it's kind of hard for me to get in there because it's tight in here. It's on right now, but you can see the green light, but you see where it says engine temp? That red light would stay on even like it is. Right now it'll be on. So if it's on, you don't have to start it or anything. It's obviously not running. But there is power to it. You can see that on switch. But that light would just stay on. You see the other check engine. It's probably oil, speed. It's probably, you know, different RPMs, oil pressure. There's quite a few. Good little diagnostic tip. So your owner's manual tells you all about that, troubleshooting and stuff. I'm sure hopefully you can get that anywhere online. So there's a generator. Anyways, there's a lot of sensors on this sucker. For many reasons. This is a cam sensor, which is kind of nice. They do label these, most of them, if you search around long enough. See that right there? Then you have other, like, air temperature sensor, obviously water flow sensor. There's a lot of sensors that can make this, speed module, oil pressure, which is right there. A lot of sensors that can make this thing shut down. That's what it was doing. It would start, run for about 30 seconds, and shut down. Okay, let's get into what I want to show you, is how difficult it is to change this dang coolant temperature sensor. All right, that's the oil pressure sensor right there. Oh, as you can see. Okay. There it is, oil pressure sensor. You see the oil filter. And back in, let me see if I can even show you. Let me see, I might not be able to even show you. But it's back in, all the way back in there. But anyways, sorry about the video. Anyways, I will show you how you can find it though. It's all the way back in there. And this is the plug right here, which is, you'll see, I mean, obviously you can see what side of it it's on, and it's labeled actually. You see that label right there? And it's all the way back underneath. Back, if you're looking at it, it's behind where your coolant is. And around and back underneath this whole cap. See that whole cap? Which, that's when I called them up, they said you should take that whole cap off, and you could see how much issue it is to take that sucker off. The one thing that he said is really hard to line back up is this cam sensor, and it has to be top dead center to line that up when you put it back on. So I was like, oh my gosh, I don't want to deal with all that. Anyway, so I took the oil filter off. I could get in there fairly good. Still very hard. But then I took the oil presser center off, which you could see it there. I accidentally broke taking it off, but I got it off and got it out of there. I had to make a special tool. Not that special, but I had to cut a notch in this sucker. 7/16, that's what it is. Put that around the wire, and I was able to crank it out in there. It's all the way back in there, which was hard. After everything was off, you could do it. The other hard part is getting it back on. It worked. It's all working good now. Just very difficult, very frustrating to get to it. It could be done without taking this whole top off. By the way, the timing belt is under here. So if you have to get to that for some reason, you got to take that off. The other two belts on this engine, there's a water pump driven belt, which you can see the water pump right there. Obviously that's raw water pump driven. And that belt, as well as the generator drive belt, is all the way at the bottom of the generator, which you'll see in your manual. So you have to take the entire generator and lean it to its side out of the boat or wherever you have it installed somehow and get to the belt. hopefully you could adjust it without doing that, but you could see all that in your manual. Just wanted to let you guys know that. So the troubleshooting on their troubleshooting manual is pretty simple. It says, hey, if it's not starting, it starts up, but it dies off. It's probably a sensor or a few, fuel or air block somewhere. So I went ahead and bought the software program for this sucker. I showed you earlier on another video exactly where to plug that into, which was a little difficult. But here's the software program. This is the cable you get with it. It's a USB cable. Right, and this is where you plug it into your computer. This is the plug that goes to your generator. And I had to buy an external CD drive because I don't know who has CD players anymore or drives. Not even my home computer had one. And anyway, so I had to do that, download it. Make sure you download the right firmware software onto your computer, because it will not pick it up unless you do that. I showed exactly how to figure that out with my other video. So you know, it's actually, you can see the control panel here. I had to take off my whole control panel and it's right back in here. It's pretty easy, just those four screws. You take those screws off, the panel comes out, leave all the wires on, and you'll see a little cap, round cap right in there. And you plug it into there. And if you, in the firmware, my firmware numbers were shown on a sticker inside. So that's how you figure out your firmware. Alrighty. So if you guys have a failure on your Westerbeke gas 3.5 generator, and you're pretty sure it's a temperature sensor, coolant temperature sensor, I hope this helps you. Another little tip I got for you. I'm in salt water, so what I always do when I get back is flush this sucker out with fresh water. Now, I'm actually on a float. This is only a 27-foot boat, so I could put it up on a float. So I'm out of the water. But if you're not out of the water, you can still do it. This is the raw water filter, and there is the seacock. If you're in the water, you shut that seacock off, obviously. Come over here, take that cap off, and have a hose, put the hose ready, so you have a stop on, I just kink it, and once you start the generator, let the water flow, keep that thing full, and let it flow for 5 to 10 minutes, and you'll flush it out with fresh water. That will save that, heat exchanger, which is right there, and make it last way, way longer than leaving salt water in there. the entire time, and that includes all the parts that salt water touches. So just a little quick tip on how to preserve your heat exchanger to last many more years than, I don't know, 2-3 years if you leave salt water in there. You can almost do that with any type of boat. Actually, you can just shut off the any type of raw water boat. All right, this video is long enough. I hope you guys, hope this helps you. If you have issues with the Westerbeke at all, let me show you the temperature sensor number on there. See, there it is. You just go to Westerbeke website. You can order it right off there. I couldn't find too much of a better price anywhere else, so I just buy it directly from them. That's the part number 042198. If you need an oil pressure sensor like I was, and I took this sucker off, I twisted it too hard up top compared to where you're supposed to twist it, and that sucker is right there. And I actually bought that locally. Luckily somebody had it. It was a little more actually than buying it on Westerbeke's site. There's just a little bonus for your water impeller, raw water impeller. You see that? Here's another shot. This is the brand new one I bought for the oil pressure sensor. And there are the belts, which hopefully I don't ever have to change, because that sounds like a big pain. Anyways, later guys, this is on a 27 foot, pretty small vessel, Ranger tug. Great boat, love it. But sometimes a little frustration comes along with the sucker. Anyways, have a great day. And give me a like and subscribe if this helps you out later.